In the summertime, it's their roosting season, so they're looking for a place to shelter for their babies. This gives a perfect opportunity for bats to be in your attic, looking for your roof, under the eaves, in the gutters, anything that would give them shelter. So therefore, this gives them a perfect opportunity to get inside your house. A possible exposure constitutes as any bite that would penetrate the skin or any exposure to a mucous membrane, such as like a cut, an abrasion, or anything like that. Some common exposures would be your dog catches a bat in the yard. If you were to be cleaning out your gutters and you come across a bat and it bites you as you're cleaning your gutters, as well as if a bat is found in your bedroom while you were sleeping. If there's a bat exposure, every effort should be made to capture the bat safely so that we can have it tested for rabies. This will determine if you need rabies prophylaxis. If you find a bat in your house, please call animal control. They will help assist in determining if the bat needs to be tested. Don't ever handle bats without protective gloves. As a reminder, rabies is a medical urgency, not a medical emergency. Therefore, we would only recommend testing a bat for rabies if there's been an exposure. We highly recommend that people keep their dogs and cats up to date on their rabies vaccine.